There are a few types of people in this world. Those who love Twitter, those who love Kanye West on Twitter, those who could care less about Twitter, and those who have fled Twitter because, well, because of a lot of things. Twitter's in trouble, not only because it isn't attracting new users, but current users of the service are becoming less active. Twitter's aggressively releasing new features and fixes, but is it really addressing the biggest frustrations? Now, I'm one of those Twitter lovers, so I tracked down dozens of my followers who have left the service to find out why. And no, it wasn't because of my bad tweets.
My biggest problem with Twitter is the newsfeed. If I'm away from it for any amount of time at all, it's very confusing to me when I come back.
And that's the complaint I've heard the most, and the one Twitter's actively improving. The timeline consists of a long reverse chronological list of the tweets from people you follow. But a new setting puts tweets that Twitter thinks you'll care most about at the top of your feed. It's similar to Facebook, and I found it very useful. Too bad Twitter's buried the switch to turn it on in its iOS, Android, and web apps.
I didn't really know who I was tweeting to. No one responded, so I stopped tweeting.
There are some solutions to this, but the best one may be accepting that Facebook is for conversation and Twitter is mainly a spectator sport. You can try to get more followers by improving your tweets with short videos and photos. The new GIF button is an attempt to help with that. You can also use and add hashtags to join conversations. And you know who will likely listen when you need them to? Many customer service accounts for brands. But it's okay to use Twitter only as a newswire for the latest on politics, sports, celebrities, etc. The new Moments tab makes it easier to get news, but you can also try a service like Nuzzle, which makes it easy to see the top stories being circulated by your followers.
I'm really tech savvy, but I just find it complicated and hard to understand. Sometimes I just think I'm not using it right.
Chances are you weren't using it right, and you're not entirely to blame. Learning Twitter is like learning a secret language of pound signs, at symbols, retweets, DMs, you name it. Sure, Twitter has released some instructional videos, but some of these features need some more basic explanation. So retweets are quotes, but quote tweets are new tweets? There are more features on the way, though, that will keep making the service easier to use, including a way to respond to a friend so everyone can see your response, no awkward period needed, a way to find new people to follow, and an option to write longer than 140-character tweets. Those features aren't arriving fast enough, though. People are sticking with Facebook, which has taken some of the best attributes from Twitter. Still, if you're a Twitter quitter, or you've never used the service, the new timeline and other tweaks make it worth a shot. I mean, where else are you gonna get this kind of pressing news?